This problem demonstrates the continuity equation in integral form. And as you may recall, our governing equation is ddt over the control volume, rho dv, which is volume, plus over all the control surfaces, rho v dot n, where both v and n are vectors, n is the unit normal vector, dA equals zero. So let's take a problem here. So we have an entrance. It's a 2 foot wide channel and it has a uniform velocity flow. So we'll make it look like this. Downstream, the velocity profile is no longer uniform, and in fact, it is a profile such that u equals 3y minus y squared. So if the downstream height of the channel is 1.5 feet and the velocity, uniform velocity here, is 2 feet per second, what we are looking for is the height at the entrance of the channel. So let's start with our governing equation. Since this is steady state, this is going to be zero. And since this is water, the fluid is incompressible. So with an incompressible flow, what we can assume is Q1 equals Q2. Now with our uniform velocity, we can say V1A1, there's our Q1, equals the integral over A2 of our u dA. The reason we have to keep this in the integral is that u is a function of the area. In particular, it's a function of y, and y is in the upward direction. So the first thing that we'll do is we will define our dA in terms of dy. So since the width is constant, dA is w dy. And now let's replace this with our Q1 equals Q2. So we have V1 times W times this height that we're trying to find equals W. And the integral from 0 to 1.5, because that's the height of that downstream channel, 3y minus y squared dy. And if you notice, the widths cancel out, so we didn't even need to know that it was 2 feet wide. So let's do this integral. We have V1 times h equals 3/2 y squared minus 1/3 y cubed integrated from 0 to 1.5, and that equals 2.25 feet squared per second. So our h is that 2.25 feet squared per second divided by our uniform velocity, which is 2 feet per second, and our height at the entrance of the channel is 1.125 feet.